Hi everybody, my name is Lakshmi and I'll be moderating this session. And I'm one of the Drishti heads in Christ University in the Bangalore Central Campus. And we also have Pranjal and Chirag here, who are the Drishti representatives of the Panargeta campus and the Kengeri Christ University campus respectively. So yeah, I think before we begin with the meeting, let's start off with an introduction session, a small icebreaker of sorts with all of you.
Hi guys, my name is Arjun Verma. I'm from Orpheus Productions, and it's been really long since we've done anything related to theater. So even a panel discussion seems fun enough. You know, like I was just wondering, you know, what we do in theater that would be in panel discussion. But I guess it makes sense if, you know, different production houses get together and discuss these things. I've been in Orpheus Productions for 3 years now, and I'm in my third year, of course. And we've done plenty of plays. We've been to Mood Indigo, VIT Vellore. In fact, last year we even placed at Mood Indigo. So overall, we are a really fun production house. And I think one thing that is quite, you know, different about our production house is that as such, not nobody, maybe that's true for other production houses as well, but at least in our production house, no single person makes a script. It's always, you know, a process that's ongoing. And I think that not just in our production house, but any other production house where it happens, it really brings the team together, because you feel more connected to the play. Because when I do a particular scene, I feel like, oh yes, I have a contribution to this. So, you know, when people appreciate this particular scene, it's credit to me. So I guess when everybody gets involved in the making process, things get, you know, a lot more streamlined.
Hi guys, Sudhanshu here from Nuts and Bolts Production, and we're from Christ University, the main campus. And our production house is from the Science and Humanities Deanery of the university. So we started out as the Science Deanery team because we didn't have any representation in our college level, as in for our deanery for science. We were mostly all bunch of nerds who weren't interesting enough for the entire college to take notice. So yeah.
Hi, this is Amarjeet, and I'm from Bits Goa Drama Club. Our street play contingent is called Elan. It was a tag given to us by our seniors, and we bear that with pride. So we go around, perform street plays for different colleges, for different college audiences. We've been to In Bloom and Moodai, other than our college. And we also start the Goan chapter of Manthan, which is the worldwide street play fest. And we perform for audiences throughout Goa as well.
So hi everyone, I'm Anisha. I am from Delhi, first of all, and I am from Bharatiya Vidya Peeth University, Institute of Management and Research, and I am the president of the Theatre Society, and it's named Swang. And again, the title was given us to us by our seniors. And we perform, basically our society is performing for NGOs. We have performed for children empowerment, women empowerment, menstruation, the topics related to menstruation. We have done that. We were in collaboration with Rotaract Club.
Hey guys, my name is Basna Sarangi. I'm from Adoc Productions. So we are from the Bangalore Central Campus. We are a pan-university team. So we get to work with people from science, humanities, BBA, law, and almost all the fields. So it creates a very diverse experience for all of us. Every fest we go to is like a box of memory, because we are one close-knit family. It's like off theater, on theater, we just can't live without each other. So that's about it.
Hi guys, this is Pranay from Team Akrosh. And we represent the Department of Professional Studies from Christ. We're a very small family. We started off with just 15 people in 2014, and now we're a pretty decent sized family. And recently this year only, we also started a proscenium wing, and it's been going on pretty well. And I guess that's it.
Hi, my name is Jewel Garg, and I'm for Zealous Productions, guys. That's a team from the Christ College, main campus. I have been a part of the team for like around 2 years now. And so, you know, as everyone says that every team is like a family or something like that, we take it quite literally. I mean, I think one very unique part about our team is that we're actually a family. All of us, are, you know, like together, and we've been doing like this. And we're the oldest team in Christ.
Oh.
So I guess, yeah. So that gives us quite a lot of experience in this field. And yeah, I've been a part of all the art forms. Personally, I love doing street theater work. Yeah, that's about it.
Hi, my name is Shashank. I am part of this theater group called the Sharam Theater Group. We are from Christ Kengri campus. So basically the only active team from the Christ Kengri campus. I started this team 4 years ago when I joined in first year because there was no street theater except for Drishti, and I wanted something to take part in competitions still. And Drishti doesn't usually take part in college fest and competitions. It is more about going to the streets and performing for the social good. So we started this team as with the label Sharam. So we can tell the bystanders who watch the scenes in the street and don't raise their voices. So our motto was Sharam mat karo. So like you have to raise your voice if something is happening on the street and you are not being a part. Like you're watching it and not doing anything about it. So that was our motto. Later we went on for Proscenium and Mind. So yeah, the team is 4 years old. I will graduate next year most probably if the lockdown goes well. And we started from a team of 15. Now we are 45 strong. And yeah, that's it for me.
Hi guys, good evening. This is Prateek from Zarya Productions. This is my second year in Zarya. And last year, Zarya Productions focused on topics like discrimination of all sorts. And we also focused on old age, and I would like to relate with Arjun. Like Arjun said, in Zarya Productions, we make sure that we give everyone a chance to speak, because we never know who has a better vision and who can, you know, give us a better idea, a better perspective to change the world, to change the society.
I think Pranjal can give us a small introduction about ourselves, about Drishti and the organization a little bit.
Drishti is a theater wing of, say, Drishti symbolizes vision, and we at Drishti try to reach out to as many people as possible through our campaigns and our plays, and we try to sensitize them on social issues such as child labor, women empowerment, human trafficking, environment related issues, then child rights, water conservation, civic sense, and personal hygiene and sanitation. Also, we try to reach out to these people by performing at various public platforms such as slums, malls, villages. Like one of you was talking about that we performed at Vega City, and we also perform in college campus to sensitize students from our own college. We also collaborate with NGOs such as Oasis, Vimochana, and many other NGOs.
First question that we're going to discuss for today is, how do you guys make the play happen? Like, what goes on behind the scenes, from choosing a topic to making the play happen and delivering the message? What goes on between that?
So about this question, I think so what people see in a 12-30 minute long screenplay is not actually what goes behind. I mean, to be honest, I think when you select a topic, that is one of the most crucial points of okay. So that takes a lot of time. I mean, if you talk about us, like during this lockdown also, like our team has been discussing lots of topics on WhatsApp and all. We have our Zoom meetings and all. So basically, I think a theater artist can never stop working, because this process is a very long. So it's a constant thing, and I love how all of us have this approach now that whenever we see anything, can just directly link it with our theater. It's like, yeah, I can use this in our standard. So that approach, though, that makes you distinct from what others are.
Most of the times, I think, when the ones that are production houses here, most of the times when we get into the process of making a play, it's before a certain, like, you know, maybe a month or 2 months before a certain fest. So we know when it's a Christ play, we have a lot of guidelines. So a lot of the times the topic we choose has to be within the limits of that. And how we go about doing that is, you know, everyone who's willing and available at the time will come join the meeting. They'll pitch their ideas, and it doesn't necessarily have to be the entire script. It could be the basic idea, and then we vote upon it. Once we choose the idea, then we hold auditions for the same. And, you know, everyone can audition for all the three or any two or any one. It's all about how you manage it, because at the end of the day, we ensure that there are no clashes. So if you can do all three, it's completely up to you.
Main procedure to make a play and choose a topic has to this point has been is more based on choosing unique topics and being more introspective rather than extrospective. And we kind of believe that a play which maybe it has a topic of pedophilia, we've done that, a play about pedophilia for a college audience. So it seems kind of odd, but even such a play could, you know, kind of trigger a person's psyche and attend to some layer of his mindset, a violent layer or any sort of play. So it a play about a play, obviously it has to necessitate to what audience we're performing, but it also needs to be very subtle about what take-home value that play actually holds, and that can be ensured by making the procedure more smooth and having good discussions about the same.
We as a team, we look for topics that are unconventional, that are normally not spoken about. Things like hyper-masculinity and things like sex education. So these are things that are normally not spoken about. Like, we did sex education in 2014 in Christ. We were very scared, but I guess the seniors pulled it off. So when we started off, we start off with a lot of research. We try and bring out points that are normally not known of. So I didn't know, personally, when we were researching about hypermasculinity, I didn't know that 76% of all suicides are done by men. So things like this, they put a different light to a topic. So that's what we focus more on, something that is unconventional and different, but needs a voice.
When it comes to choosing a topic, we go for relatability the most. So we did a street play on our intra-college Dharpan festival. We did a play on police brutality. So it was directly related to the experiences faced by the members of the productions.
Oh.
So we live near SD Palya, which adjacent to Christ. And all sort of things happen there. So that's really close to us, and we have experience. We don't need to research for facts to get to know what's wrong. We know what's wrong and we want to correct it. So there was another thing that drug abuse. So something that's really close to us, we do a play on that, which the students relate to a lot.
Starting with how we select the script is usually what latest is in the news. Supposedly a few years ago, when the Section 377 was cancelled off and it was changed, so we did plays on how LGBT community have to face problems. If I'm taking an example, as at this present moment, if anyone asked me to do a play, I would do plays on the latest news about the elephant dying, because people have different opinions. Also, adding to Arjun's point, I understand that we have to go into the streets and showcase more, but what I have seen is that when our street play teams go for competitions, we focus more on the acting part, and we show the street plays in such a good manner to get the points of the judges. And I'm a part of history as well. What I have felt between the difference between normal street play teams and history is, even though history script, the plays are not strong, jumps and bamboos and all the colors and powders and strong beats, end of the day, Drishti is able to deliver its message better. The play is simple and the people are able to view it. While the street play teams, if we go out in the street and do the same plays, people will start looking at our flips and sounds and beats, and they won't focus their attention to the message.
If we compare our plays, in general, when I saw the plays in at least in the Bangalore circuit, our plays are very, let's have a big formation, let's scream very loudly, let's write very detailed, meaningful poems. It's good. It's really quality content. But what we don't understand is, when you compare it with plays that come to Mood Indigo or from Delhi, Miranda House, they're very simple plays. They'll have a beautiful tune in the flute, which you'll get hooked to, and then you won't be able to stop listening to what they have to say. They didn't have very exorbitant formations or, very well-written, very simple words they got the message across. And they also, plays at the competition. Whereas on the other hand, I feel we are sometimes, we have to represent ego, so we'll make this big thing. Or maybe, we have to show sadness, so let's do this thing. Everyone is going, oh, let's just keep it simple, how about that? that's something the audiences will also understand.
Firstly, we just hold a meeting. Like, it doesn't have an agenda. We just hold it because we are very large in terms of the population. So everyone needs to talk. And the first thing we do is create a safe space for them to pitch us topics later, because everyone's just like, do we have to pitch it? Not so. We first we create a space for them, and then we start with the scripting meetings where we encourage them to tell us their topic in terms of a story. Like, if you can explain your topic in terms of a story and it emotionally connects to us, that means that we can make a play out of it. Like, it just can't be facts, it just can't be, you know, visuals as I suggested, the formations and everything. It needs to have a story which needs to have a message. So we encourage them to find that first. Then there's a lot of filtration which goes on in terms of the relatability, in terms of what can be done in college. And there's a lot of difference when it comes to street and our college, because when we went for the fest, we took our play on traffic because we thought that was the most relatable play which we could take to the street for the CSA event. And we didn't have any formation. We changed all the dialogues, we changed everything. And that happened while we were performing, not before we were practicing. A lot of things were so spontaneous, and hats off to you guys. You guys are really spontaneous because we can't manage spaces. We are given so much of space to do one performance. And the places which we were given there, we were some 40 people in one very close-knit place, and everyone was around us. We didn't have place to move, forget formations, dance and music, forget that. So that was a really great experience.
I would like to add one more point, that how we as a team go for a place. See, I think nowadays street play are getting very monotonous, right? So we as a team try to bring in the fact of humor in a street play. So that makes it more relatable and good for the eyes, for the audience. Like, there is loud energy, there is loud, a dash of humor, energy, and, you know, loudness makes it visually more appealing to the audience, and makes it easier for us to convey our message. Like, for example, the last play I did was on manual scavenging. I'm sure we haven't seen many plays on that topic, right? So, you know, even in that play, we managed to somehow put off some kind of comedy in it, which doesn't make it plain for the audience. Like, it can't be so just serious, home, like, allowed, like, very energetic, homey. So this is what I feel.
So I just want to share an instance what happened. We went to an slum area to perform a play on menstruation, right? I had a friend, he went to that area only, and they went for a very big 20 to 20 minutes and 22 minutes of play, and they went with too many props, too many complicated things, and many much more. So when we went to that slum area, we kept it 10 minutes of play and very simple. The points like we saw in that movie Padman, the girls used to live outside the home when they were on their cycles and everything. We just mentioned that we did it, and two of the girls who used to live there, they came to us, they started crying, and I went to them and I just asked them what happened and everything. So they just told me that we weren't able to make our parents understand the point. I wanted to make my father understand. She didn't have her mother, so she wanted to tell her father. So she took my president to him. He was a male, so we found appropriate that he should talk to him, and he talked to him. And just then the father went to the medical shop and bought a sanitary napkin and gifted it to her daughter. So that was a very, very, very good experience we had during that play. I just wanted to mention that it's very important to make our plays, to make our content according to the normal people, according to the people who need this information.
As we were talking about simplification, simplification has two sides. One, that the audience understands. Second, it's also easier to make a play that isn't so complex. So I remember this one time, we had to show one emotion and we made a simple scene. One person came in, he's like, no, I think we should make big formation. Everyone's like, oh, big formation, cool. Big formation is awesome. So we made big formation and we got into the depths like, oh my God, if this one hand comes out, maybe they'll think this. If two hands come out, they'll think this. The entire week, the team was in pressure because of that one scene. And somewhere it may have affected the performance. Got over, I went into the audience, talked to some people. I'm like, did you guys enjoy it? They're like, wow, that formation was amazing. I'm like, did you know what it meant? You guys were trying to show something, right? That it's something that you're angry. And when that person just simply says that you guys are angry, I'm like, do you know the amount of thought that went into each and every hand positioned in that? So it's a lot of effort that gets wasted on the team side as well. So it could save us a lot of time and, you know, pressure on the day of performance if we made plays a little simpler.
Okay, so I partially agree with Arjun. Like Arjun said, the play should be simple. Definitely the play should be simple. There should not be, you know, too many complex elements. But when we represent ourselves in competitions, we make sure that we put out our best. And like I've also worked with Drishti. I've done quite a lot of plays with Drishti now. And one thing I've realized is that when Drishti comes up with a simple scene, for example, just like there's a throne being made. I've seen that people see that when Drishti goes and performs in slums. People see that. People, people catch it and they come to see it. So definitely I would like to say that we should represent our best when we go to slums also.
Right. So I completely agree that the whole competitive street play scene has engulfed the real motive behind the street play. And I feel that this is also being reflected in how the social unrest is there in like the current paradigm on social media, right? So I feel that most of the current college audience that comes and watches our plays has a very polarized view about, they're very opinionated, obviously, but they necessarily don't understand the details of a particular topic, the two sides. They know that there are two sides, A and B, and they will just side with a particular point just because it's more visually appealing and it's very, it has more immediate gratification that, you know, like we can just side with it. And I feel that there needs to be empathy in a play. We don't have to lower our standards. Obviously, like more impact can be created without any sorts of, you know, four-man pyramid or whatever. But like if empathy is one key ingredient that we add to our play, more easily we can like streamline the whole process. Case in point, you know, if you take the current paradigm, like there was a whole internet social media drama about the whole boys locker room issue, and it just turned out into a boys versus, you know, girls bashing scene on the internet, where it should have been a discussion on how boys should actually be. So people just sided with a particular point, whereas they could have had, you know, addressed the gray matter more rather than just the black and white. And even during the Black Lives Matter versus All Lives Matter, why are people not talking about, you know, how like upward mobility for black people is not working, and it has just turned into a fight between two races. So yes, that is something we need to bring out more in our place.
Okay, Sudhansha, I'm really sorry, we need to move on because we're stuck at the same question. So next question is, how relevant do you think street theater is, like this form of theater, and how is it different from other forms of theater? What do you guys think about that? Do any of you have a point?
Yeah. So what I feel is, like, when we are comparing theater, let's take, for example, mime, curtain theater and street theater. So mime and curtain theater are a luxury part of theater. People go there, sit in auditoriums and view it as to pass their times and part of the luxury. While street theater is, people don't come to watch it. We make them watch it and we acquire them on the street. We go on the streets, we bang our drums, and it is very repulsive in other way from other theaters, because street theater is more about letting your voice being heard, and the curtain and mime theaters are about showing how good of an actor you are. So that is what's the basic difference.
Street play, what the distinct thing about straight men that we make our own movies. One is gonna sit there waiting for you that yeah, this team's gonna come and perform for some much of like if you compare it from the CM and straight play, we make our own audience. Secondly, I have realized this one. So I find Proscenium is also one of the most difficult platforms. So I think Proscenium is more of a mental pain, but Street is more of a physical pain. It's like for months and all, you know, feet get hurt. So this is a like very practical difference that I feel is there.
Yeah, so the point is simple that for comparing street theater to anything else, it's like it's basically about the cause. And street theater in India, like everyone has an opinion. You get 15 to 20 minutes just to put your opinion in front of 20 to 30 people. That's a small crowd. We get 50 to 100 people. But that opportunity really excites me. That's why I like street theater. That's what's different from other things, from proscenium and everything. And it has a like a beginning, end, and a solution. See, so we go there. We start with, we attract the audience. We tell them that this is the problem with the society. How is it affecting you and everybody around us? And in the end, we tell them this is the small steps or the things you can do that will help reduce this problem. So it has a beginning, middle, and an end. You get that satisfaction that you had something to say, and you got an audience, and you got to say it. And like the connection I was talking about earlier, that you go in front of a person, look them in the eye, and say that you are doing this wrong. Please stop doing it. There are ways to change it, and we'll tell you how to change it.
So I would like to add that street theater, as it is mentioned, it is like in terms of accessibility, we reach to a wider audience and the audience is diverse. So we have to think a lot about how we construct the play, which caters to all the kinds of audience. And another thing is that when we talk about the other forms of theater, the stories can be something which is very hypothetical and something which is made out of the blue. But when it comes to street theater, it needs to be something which is very real, something which is very close and connecting. And I think that is more difficult to think about than, like, you know, there's a thought process which goes on for every form of theater. But for street, I think we really need to think about more in terms of what the real issues are, in terms of what are the consequences, repercussions. So a lot of thought goes into it.
When we are talking about street theater, even in street theater, there are different kinds of audience. For example, in Drishti, we made two different plays. Like we made a play about, you know, human trafficking and all of that. And we had this very intense scene where a girl is getting molested and all of that. And there is a different set of audience for that. We did another play in a government school. And there we had this genie coming in telling a kid about self-confidence and all of that. Was completely, if we did the same play in a street and not in a school, it would have been, everybody would have laughed at us. So even in street theater, I think we need to look at the kind of audience and you know, choose how we're gonna structure the whole play.
So when it comes to street theater, when you compare it with the other forms of theater, I feel you can get more people involved and the limits and the restrictions are lesser for us, is what I feel. It's just my opinion. And one more thing is that in street theater, when we go ahead with our points, like we have to be, like you said, we have to be careful about what our audience perceives. Agreed. But when Shashank said that, you know, you have to be careful about the, like, we might oversimplify, we can also simplify our plays and, you know, not have fancy formations, which I agree to. But I remember once before, I mean, I did not, but when my team went out and performed for CSA, once we went to, I don't remember the locality correctly, but we did perform in the streets and we started off with a huge, we started off with suno, 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 and, you know, gather people around. And when we started making our formation, I could see people coming in, running in, and they were all excited. But at the same point, at the same time, after the play was over, people did understand what was going on in the scene. So I feel instead of simplifying, everyone has their own ways of putting out their point, and I feel, you know, it differs from team to team and productions to productions.
So it's just my opinion. I feel that street theater cannot be compared to any form of theater, because first of all, street is a mix of emotions. Like, you need to be physically and emotionally and mentally be present there. Physically, because, you know, you'll always have to be at the peak of your voice. And mentally, because you need to make sure that, you know, you are audible to the audience. You are, like, trying to relate to the audience, and that's why your voice matters a lot. That's why I think that street cannot be compared to any form of theater. It's a mix of emotions. And yeah, like others said, it's about the way we present it. Yeah.
Basically, what I wanted to say, you need to be very active while doing street. I mean, also street theater is totally different from other forms, because street is basically done with some purpose of creating awareness, be it political awareness or social awareness. At CSAB, basically work for to create social awareness, but it's very important to have a message, a social message in a street play, I guess. And like, if we see proscenium and mime, they're also done for the purpose of entertainment. And when we see street teams performing, even in the college for competition, they have some issue, like they have some cause there. So it's like, I think the cause makes it different from the other theater forms.
This point might sound stupid to some, but the entertainment street play has. So no other art form has the entertainment street play has. So if you see a group of 15 people wearing a kurta and they hear the drum, they start dancing. No other dance form, like the other theater group, would do that. Like, we're really spontaneous. We just want to dance. We want to yell. We want to make faces at the audience. That's really exciting to us. So all the productions here, I've watched all Zealous, same campus. So I've watched their play Akrosh, Ad Hoc. Orpheus, I've watched their Bekhabar play, street play. So I really love the jingles. Bits Pilani Goa, I've watched their entry for the Baptizer Fest. So, like, I've watched all of them, and I listen to them on loop. That's how entertaining I find them. Like, they have a message with it, but the way they write it, the way the sound beats are, it's really entertaining to hear as well. So, yeah.
Since this is a discussion on theater, I think we should give attention to other forms as well. I want to talk about what I enjoy in proscenium, because I've done more street plays, but the prosceniums that I've done, I really enjoy, because I feel like in proscenium you can really layer emotions into the scene. Like, I enjoy the fine tuning you can give to the emotions. Like, it's fun to see different variations of angry on the same stage at the same time. So I enjoy that, you know, every scene can be fine-tuned to feel a certain emotion to a certain extent. Whereas on the other hand, street play is a little bit, everything is mode push. Everything is to the maximum. If we are angry, we are really angry. If we are, you know, sad, we are really sad. If we are happy, we are very happy. But on the other hand, you know, proscenium is more like, it's a steady tone. And unlike street play in general, even if whether we are competing or if we are showing to others, It's always going to have this element of social cause. It's not storytelling in the purest form, is what I'd like to say. It's of course, you're showing something, you're showing a play, but storytelling is in the purest form is, I think, proscenium, because of course you can do plays on social cause, but what if I just want to tell you a story?
I think street play has evolved so much that nowadays, like, even if we have proscenium in street. Nowadays, street plays have been following a story format where you can actually play emotions and all. You can actually do a proper proscenium kind of a street play. That is a very, very good mix. And Drishti, mentioned that play about a genie. And that is a play by Zealous.
Yeah, I would like to add on to what Ujjwal said. Like he said, street play is evolving, and we're bringing in aspects of proscenium and mime. In fact, we in Team Akrosh also did a mime scene in a street play for Darpan. And I think it did click, and people did understand what was going on. So I feel in street play, proscenium aspect and mime aspect can be involved. But I don't think the same can be said for proscenium and mime. So that was my point.
My opinion is that Pausanias leaves a storyline that you can remember. No one remembers the story of his TP, they just remember the message. But if you want to narrate a story and you want the person to remember the story, it will go down in history. All the plays, all the Greek plays that we know, we still remember to this day. That is what is special about Pausanias. You remember it. Street play is just happens in a moment and we are done with it. So that is what I feel the major difference is also.
Don't you think it depends on the impact of any form of theater? It depends on how impactful it is.
See, when I see a street play myself personally of any of the productions in Christ or anywhere else, I feel goosebumps in my hand looking at the acting. I remember it for 1 week, 2 weeks. I want to do my street plays to their level. I feel so inspired. But after 2 weeks, after 1 month, I don't remember it. But when I see Pausanias, I have been part of National School of Drama for last 7 years as a junior actor. When I see Pausanias in their play, I don't want to act their way, but I want to remember the story continuously in my mind. That story just goes on in my mind again and again. So that is a real big difference out there.
Yeah, so about the variations in street theater, so I want to quote a judge during, I think, Darpan, I guess. And she said, ki tumhare Christ teams ka ye hai, ki, you know, it all starts with really good dhol, dham dham hota hai, aur sab bhaag ke aate hai. और एक टीम नहीं दो टीम नहीं सारी टीम्स वैसे ही भाग के आते ऐसा मतलब ही शी वाज लाइक शी सो स्टंड बाय द फैक्ट दैट एवरीवन कम्स टू दैट ढोल रन्स एंड देन स्टैंड्स इन अ सर्कल एंड देन स्टार्ट्स अ सॉन्ग स्टार्ट्स अ रैंट एंड एवरीथिंग सो शी वाज लाइक यू क्राइस्ट पीपल यू हैव समथिंग लाइक डिफरेंट लाइक बट इट्स अगेन इट्स द सेम अमंग ऑल ऑफ यू सो दैट वाज वन थिंग व्हिच आई वांटेड टू पॉइंट आउट इन टर्म्स ऑफ वेरिएशंस And another thing is that there was a play which we did. Its name is Kala Thela. It's not a very, it's not a play which you can do with a lot of people. It's a very 12-15 people play. And it had a lot of acting involved in it. And individual acting specifically because we were trying to show a scene of mental asylum and parents and their behavior so there were a lot of individual characters involved and the acting was moving constantly because the children in the mental asylum had to act deranged so that is the point so we can incorporate those acting skills even into our street plays
yes so like in a way summing up what has been taught I feel that You know, street plays are very is the rawest form of art that we do, like as a generation of, you know, thespians. And it has a lot of scope of improvement. We can add a lot of elements and layers to it. Like we all talked about how mime and, you know, proscenium can be added, you know, theater of the oppressed and all of that can be added. It's what differs it from stage is that stage gives you a template, whereas this is just a blank slate. And you can always, you know, add more elements and create that beauty in it.
I have a question for the panel. So, of course, we all admit, like, obviously, there are, you know, we do a little bit of mime and proscenium and theater, and it all, you know, mixes up a little. And as Ujjwal said, it's ever evolving. And I'm sure even as we move ahead, it's going to keep evolving. So, you know, nowadays we see that even some electric instruments are being used, like piano. You know, some people are using piano. So, definitely that points towards that street play is changing. But my question is that. Later, there can be a point where maybe we decide to get torches into street play, you know, for like maybe lights and we try to, you know, bring in more, say, maybe some electronic equipment. So like, where do we draw the line between that street play, ye hai, isme yahi hoga. Aur ye proscenium hai, tumhe lights and sound ke saath karna hai, to isme karo. So basically what I try to say is that where do we draw the line between these things happen only in a street play, these things happen in a proscenium and these things happen in a mime. Of course, every once in a while, things will cross over. But if we keep going like this, so at some point we'll lose what street play actually was.
But I think like what Amarjeet said, it's a blank state. And as you know, until you are in a street and it doesn't matter what you incorporate, you just perform for live audience in the streets and with a social cause, I guess. It broadly defines street theatre. Let's move to the last part of the session. It's basically, you guys can share any personal anecdotes like Anisha did about the girl, about the menstruation play and all of that. So you guys can also talk about any personal anecdotes, if there was any role that you guys took up that empowered you or changed you as a person, or any person in the audience that came up to you and told something that, you know, your play impacted me in this way.
So I did a play on physical disability, the awareness about physical disability in our college. Okay. So there were a group of like foreigners who've come to visit our college, and one of them was in a wheelchair. So while we were performing, she was watching the play. They didn't understand. We had our jingles in Hindi mostly, and a bit of English in the monologues and stuff. But after seeing the play, she was crying, which was really beautiful, because she, like, I'm pretty sure she didn't understand half of the play, but seeing the importance being given to the topic, which is close to her, is so close to her, which affects her, that made her cry. So, and after that, me and my friend directed that day, and she came up to me us, and she congratulated us. So, which is really nice. Yeah.
Yeah. So, guys, you know, last year we went for a fest to Bombay. It's called Malhar. So, you know, we went there like we had some time to practice before. Yeah. So, we went to Bombay for a fest, and as we all know, Bombay doesn't have a lot of space, right? So you don't really have a space, don't have a place to practice, something like that. So early in the morning, all of us decided, Charul, let's go to Marine Drive, because it's all peaceful and all that, and nobody would be around. So I think we went there at around 6 in the morning or something like that, and no one was there. But after some time, you see all these uncles and aunties wearing sport shoes and doing their walking, like that, okay? So yeah, we started with our dance throughs, with all the rehearsals, and as I mentioned earlier, street play, we make our own audience. That actually happened. Like, it was just a normal run through. I didn't even give my 100% in it. And after the first run through, all of the uncles and aunties, you know, they came around. They actually hugged us. So basically, the play was about abandonment. How we abandon our parents and all that. That was very, very, very emotional, relatable to that crowd. So that connect with those uncles and all, God, they came and actually hugged us. They thanked us. I still remember one uncle said, "Ki beta, ye play mere bete ke samne karke dikhana hai." Like, okay, if that's possible, I would love to do that. But I think that's what street play is all about. I mean, the feedbacks that you get from the live audience mean, to like, at least to me, mean a lot more to the, like, compared to the judge.
There are a lot of other things we can address through our street plays, which can, you know, which can be powerful as well, because we've done a lot of plays on gender differences and human trafficking and all of that, and we've seen the audience engage with us. So I think it solely depends on the sensitivity of the topic.
Right, totally. But that was just a peaceful protest. Everyone was sitting around and they just wanted to present their point. And yeah, the police having to interrupt them in the middle of it was something which was very startling for me.
I completely agree with Amarjeet Singh. Like, we should pick on sensitive topics. If people are not tolerant, they should walk away. But as a growing society, this is what we have to learn. If we aren't tolerant of each other's ideas, then okay, great. Nothing makes any sense then. Pick on sensitive topics, perform them. If people don't like it, let them come and fight with you. That's when you're actually, you know, upholding the honor of the power you hold. I have the power. I showed it to you. If you don't like it, talk to me about it. So definitely, simply because maybe we are performing in colleges or in a restricted audience, I think we should go for more sensitive topics. At the end of the day, if we all stand with it, there's nothing the management or anybody can stop us. If we all have decided that we are going to take sensitive topics, what the best they can do is stop us from doing it. Fine, we'll go outside and perform. But I think we should pick on sensitive topics, because for how long are we going to keep showing gender discrimination? Like, it's still a problem. Completely agreed. But as a lot of people mentioned, that sometimes street plays do get monotonous. So until when are you going to keep showing marital? I have seen a lot of rapes. I have seen a lot of plays on marital rape. Sorry, that came out wrong. I've seen a lot of plays on marital rape, and all of them got the message across. But how many times? There are other topics that need to be addressed. I personally haven't yet seen a case on, I haven't personally yet seen a play on maybe, I say, beef lynching. sorry, you know, or, you know, like other controversial topics like these, you know, where, you know, the Hindu or the Muslim side might get, you know, triggered, or, you know, we should really discuss those topics. And for the, like, you know, the question that was going on, the anecdotes that we had to share, I was at Moody Nigo 2018 and we were waiting for our slot. And before us, there were a lot of other teams, and outside that, it was a huge ground. So all the teams were setting up their props and everything. And, you know, you could feel the theater because there were so many teams. Everyone was acting. Everyone was painting their props. Every corner you looked was a different setup. Somewhere it was a border. Somewhere it was a house. And personally, like, we know that if I have to go on stage next, our props have to be ready. They have to be there. And, you know, like, nobody risks anything. And I was just walking across that ground and I happened to notice that a team's, it was quite a big prop and it completely broke. And it was a very essential part of their play. And it was a very sensitive prop. Now, there was another team, no relation with them. They were just practicing adjacent. They noticed this and they happened to have a similar prop. And I was there, you know, because this, all this happened. So, like, you know, I just went, I'm like, do you guys need any help? I noticed the senior from that side came. He noticed all of it. And he said, guys, it's okay. We are performing after you. So you, if you want, you use our prop. Personally speaking, there have been times when, you know, some we personally have been approached. And not because we don't want to, but it's generally because people don't want their own performances to be affected, that they generally don't tend to share these kind of things. So it was genuine team spirit, and, you know, that we are doing theater for theater, not for winning it. So, like, seeing people, you know, work together to ensure that even their rivals are, you know, able to participate, I think that was a really great feeling.
Speaking of anecdotes first, my experience, it's like in class 11th, we performed a street play in Connaught Place, that's in Delhi. So I'm basically from Delhi. And we did the street play on missing faces, that, you know, the people of faces you see on posters, missing, reward, wanted, whatever. And we don't pay any attention to them and we just look at them for 1 second and go then. We don't even remember their faces. So we did this play, about 20-minute long play, and we gathered up extreme huge amount of crowd because the Connaught Place is an extremely crowded place. Now, cut to 1 month later, we receive a news that somewhere after seeing a play, remembered seeing, like, going home and looking at the posters on a way and actually spending time on those posters. And he found some missing child on the red light. And then he called us and told us that because of you, we were able to save this person. And because of that incident, I think I have been doing street plays till now, or maybe in the further future till fate allows, because that one incident has inspired me to do all the time, because my 10 minutes or one day of practice is saving someone's lifetime. It's worth it for me. Adding to Arjun's point, I think, yes, street play was meant to be a showcase of rebellion. We were never there for the fairy tale world about water preservation or drugs abuse. Or no, street play initially was for rebelling on the street, showing others what we want, being our voices heard. So even if people don't tolerate it, even if people get triggered, till the time you think it's for a right cause, you have to do it, no matter what the cost is.
Just one small thing. Sudhanshu asked me a question in the chats that Shraddha Hashmi did a play. I haven't seen the play. And as Shashank mentioned, that's simply because, you know, the audience is intolerant. Of course, if you've made a play, we shouldn't, of course, we're not going to perform it at a single place, right? So we need to see, as long as you know that what you've showed is right, and you know it, that, see, you came on stage with a mindset that I have to show this, it is right. If the audience is intolerant of it and you change that, then what was the point of doing it in the first place?
No,
okay, fine. Maybe the audience might disagree, but I'm quite sure the entire audience wouldn't.
No, so I hope you know him, Sardar Hashmi. He was killed because of performing a play. And he is he's called like the father of street play, because, and if I'm not wrong, street play is celebrated during his birthday. We had a quiz regarding that as well. So the thing is, there's one aspect of safety when we talk about street plays, because at least in Drishti, when we perform in streets or any sensitive areas as such, you never know how the audience is going to react. You might get yourself killed as well. So
that's I didn't know about this Shafdar Hashmi incident, but of course safety is one thing, but then if you considering safety, then we should just forget about sensitive topics, because in a country like India, if you're performing street, you're on a sensitive topic, you go with the mindset that my safety is compromised. You need to have that guts and gumptions ki bros, I'm going to do a sensitive topic, things could go haywire. Otherwise, we could go on doing the same things over and over, but what would be the point?
Like, I totally agree. You need to be sure of the message you're giving out, and you need to back it up. Like, you should not be scared to give that message, but it's about your safety.
Yeah. I mean, if we have to get it across, I guess it's a trade-off, because that way, then fine. If it comes down to safety, then everyone's life is precious. Then we should altogether avoid these topics. But if we have to go for it, we have to go all out. That's what I feel. Basically, what I was trying to say, I think tolerance in people is something that will not happen all of a sudden. It is something that is an evolution of a change. So maybe, you know, more of street artists, theater artists need to die before people understand that it's legit for, you know, people to present. I mean, it sounds a little dark, but since I didn't know about the Shafdar Hashmi case, this is how I'm putting it.
I think it all comes down to freedom of expression in our country, but that's a whole other topic. Let's stick to theater now.
Yeah, so guys, lastly, I just had a question for y'all. So, since nowadays street plays across India are getting very monotonous, right? Like the structure of the play gets very monotonous. So I think nowadays there is this, I mean, Christ Steals Peace back me up here. I think nowadays there's this hunger change the structure of a street to try to somehow make it different, like as different as possible, and because of that we actually get bad, we can't like cancel many ideas just because of that factor to make it different, make it somehow appealing. So how do you guys, like if you guys face this problem, so how do you go about it, and how do you change the structure of a play that need to change a play?
Okay, Pranay has the answer for that, I'm guessing. Yeah.
Yeah, not the perfect answer, but this is what we did. Like Ujjwal said, I mean, everything is so monotonous. There's a start, there's an end, there's a solution. Right? So what we did, in fact, is for In Blooms, we changed it up. So usually this is not what teams do. So we put the end at the beginning and, you know, we started off the play like that. So we started off with a suicide and then we showed a story. So that's how we wanted to change people's idea. So we wanted to, you know, experiment with a lot of things so that, you know, we can evolve. But I think it did work out really well because we started off and then the story clicked. So that's how we changed our way of doing the play.
Right. So that is a very valid question. And usually the plays that show one side of a coin and like one particular aspect of a situation, like maybe we can try and make it somewhat of a turncoat kind of a play. So that both sides of the coin are, you know, equally addressed and people can, you know, think in both the ways. Because usually the audience just ends up looking at a very one-sided picture at the end of a play. And that's what they take back home. So that's one way we can do it.
Yeah, actually, I was going to mention the exact same word, you know, a turncoat format. And I would like to add to what Pranay said. Pranay said that, you know, they showed the suicide first. I think that's also something we've seen quite often, you know, showing a hook and then connecting the hook in the end so that the audience goes, oh, you know, that oh factor comes in the end. Even that's something we've seen a lot. I think it's more about we change, you know, a little bit of how we go about doing things. Like, let's not make formations or like, you know, something completely different. I'm constantly saying formations because it's something to do with my personal experience, but basically what we consider the, you know, say basics of street play, let's maybe try changing that up a bit. Like at least in the south side, I've noticed that discipline is prime. You have to sit like this, you know, hand like this. But on the north side, it's not so much. Maybe, you know, maybe small things like these, not specifically this, but could cause, you know, this kind of change that we're expecting.
So when it comes to changing the structure of the play, like how we do it in Christ and how so we can only learn from experience. By watching plays or by like trying out stuff, we don't get as many much opportunities to perform the entire play so often in our college, so we can learn from watching other plays. So go online, watch Theatre Kingdom videos. Like, you can learn a lot from Delhi or Delhi University teams. Like, I really love all the plays they do. You can start off with they give the summary of the entire play with the song in the beginning. That's something we haven't seen in Christ. So things like these, like you, the only thing that can change the structure is experience. If you don't have the experience, watch people with experience. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you for sharing that. Prateek's hand, he's raised his hand in the chat box. So do you have anything to say, Prateek?
Yeah, I have the same point. I think by watching more and more and by, you know, gaining experience, we can bring a change. And secondly, I think the feeling of competition should be reduced so that, you know, we can work more on delivering our message and less on the competition side. Yeah, that's all.
Thank you so much for sharing that. Pranjal, okay. Shashank, last point and then Pranjal. Okay.
Okay. It's not a, like, point-wise. I'm just, like, because everyone is here and Christ University team's representatives here, I want to suggest, like, why can't we have, like, a workshop kind of thing? Let's all get together, discuss ideas, and because even we know it's limited and we have restrictions talking about things on this platform. We can't say a lot of stuff because CSA and stuff. Why can't we have a workshop and let's discuss and, like, rant things about everything and get together to find the crux of the motive, whatever we are going to portray in our plays? So we can have that. I can take your numbers from the WhatsApp group. I can text you personally, form a group, discuss there. And maybe later when the college reopens, we can communicate Kengri campus, main campus, Benalkatta campus.
Okay, we have a new collaboration idea in going. Okay, so Pranjal had a point. Yeah, Pranjal.
Yeah, so Arjun's point, like, I catch that point and I would like to make my point on that. So you said that when we talk about street, we should forget about our safety, which I feel is not true, because safety issues come when we perform for some political issue, when they take some political issue and perform, because they are very controversial. If we take any political issue, everyone might have a different opinion for every political thing. But at Drishti, we try to focus more on social aspect, to create social awareness, which needs to be addressed in these society, in our society, because these things like women harassment, like substance abuse, these are wrong generally. These are wrong for everyone. These are not controversial topics. So basically, we take these topics and sharing my personal experience about street theater, I guess. It should impact us. Like, I joined Drishti and that was my first street play. That was my first play ever in my life. It was so good. I mean, it wasn't good from my side. I felt good. And what I feel is that by performing, we should feel impacted first before trying to create impact on others. Because that's what matters. If we create an impact on ourselves, if we think about what cause we're performing for and we feel it, I think we feel very energetic and excited to deliver that message. If we feel that this thing is right, then we will be more, like, we'll be able to deliver that message to people more easy, like, in a very easier way. So I guess that's what matters, that we should feel impacted by the cause we're performing for. I guess that's it. And guys, it was really good to hear all of your points. It was really amazing session. And definitely, I love the idea of Shashank, that should have a workshop. Sorry. Yeah. It was really nice, guys. Yeah, Lakshmi, over to you.
Okay. So I think that brings us to the end of the session. Thank you so much for joining us. It was wonderful having you guys here. And I really enjoyed the conversation and the different perspectives you had regarding so many different things. And I hope we can you know, do this sometime. Maybe one of you can host something like this, or anything would do. So yeah, we had a great time, guys, and thank you so much for being here. So you guys would like to say any one-liners or any bye, thank you note or anything before ending the session? Any suggestions, feedback or anything? None? Okay.
Guys, just saying that let's just have another call. We don't even have to meet. Let's just have another call and discuss this off. Got it.
All right. Okay. Thank you so much for joining us and sharing your perspectives. The video is recorded. So, yeah.